Start this morning session. Morning flaws. Early birds. Okay. And Professor should be give his fifth lecture in this morning course.
Yeah, I think in the first day I introduced Euler graph, Hamiltonian cycle, and Hamiltonian paths. Euler is easy. Hamiltonian is difficult. Right? So easy part, the difficult part is how to parish, and the difficult part is Hamiltonian cycle is very, very difficult. So, but as you see, day before yesterday, I introduced four tolerant Hamiltonian cycle, and we do have some progress, right? And so now we go. So I really want to challenge you. What can I do next? Because I do saw something, and what is the next? So you know, this is really important. You know, because I do saw some conjecture, Lovasz conjecture, when I was PhD. Then I got really stuck because I had no problem to do next. So finding next problem is really important. So what is global star connected? So here is the puzzle. The puzzle is the prince and the centaurera. And the prince want to find a way because to marry centaurera. So he tried to find a Hamiltonian path to marry Cinderella, the parade. It's very good, you know, the parade is very good. But he is really, really eager to marry with Cinderella. So he proposed another parade action that divided by two groups. One group here. And the other group here. Okay? So maybe faster. Right? He eager to marry. Okay? Then he's still not satisfied. Then one pass here. And two pass here. And three pass here. This is the best that you can do, right? You cannot improve anymore, right? So globally star, you play the game again and again and again by reallocate these two vertices, reallocate these vertices, and try to find the three internal disjoint spanning paths between these two vertices. Okay, this is it seems a puzzle, yeah, it is indeed. And can you solve maybe easier problem? So any two vertices, you can do it without any difficulty. Okay? So what is the relation behind what I have done before? Well, one star connected. I mean, what is one star? Any two vertices you want to find a path spanning, you know, three star means I call it three star because any two vertices you have one path, one spanning path. This is Hamiltonian connected. One star is actually Hamiltonian connected. And what is two star? You see two star again. Here's two star. It is actually Hamiltonian cycle. Right? So 1, 2, 3, then you can 3, 4, 5, 6 later, right? So you have something to do, right? Okay. You really, yes, indeed, you have something to do. Yeah. Okay. So what is the relation of globally star? I mean, a cubic graph is globally star. Any two vertices, you can find the three internal disjoint paths between these two vertices. I mean, indeed, I must teach the young people something. Yeah. This is a 1H for tolerant Hamiltonian and 1 vertex for tolerant Hamiltonian. How to prove it? The proof is very easy. Because, okay, any AD is 40. Any AD. Since X and Y, any two vertices, you have three internal disjoint pairs. So this is the three internal disjoint pairs you find. And the red one plus the green one, the blue one and the green one is Hamiltonian cycle. You can prove, not just a single age, just any age, the proof is the same. It's the same. It is proof. So, if I want to prove any vertex is 4, you pick any vertex. You pick the two vertices around you, and you try to find the three internal disjoint pairs. Again, it is one vertex for tolerant Hamiltonian. Everybody know. I think any high school student is easy, right? So yesterday, day before yesterday, I have said. Something about the three joint. How about the situation for three joint? How about the case for three joint? Okay. So let's begin the puzzle. There's any two vertices here. Any two vertices. I want to play the puzzle. This is this graph is three joint by two graph, right? Then I want to prove any two vertex. So any two vertex is either from the same country or different country, right? So if that is come from same country, then the proof is first solve your own problem in your country. Then since you don't use this link, so this the corresponding A is 40, and you try to find a. Hamiltonian cycle, then you join it, you get a solution. Right? Maybe too easy, yeah. How to prove any two vertices? Then the proof is you solve the problem here, the joint vertices, and the joint vertices to the other vertices, then you combine it, you prove it. Is that proof? I think that's easy, right? You will get this concept is if and only if. You join two good graph, and even if you can separate this, it's still good. Yeah. So, is that too fast? So let's compare. Here is the set of cubic Hamiltonian graph, and here this region is globally three star connected, and this is cubic for one for tolerant Hamiltonian graph. So, since every global three star is a one for tolerant Hamiltonian sphere, so you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 region. However, we have already discussed 5 and 6. This is these two region has already discussed in day before yesterday. So. I should discuss 1, 2, 3, 4. One is easy. All the graph in category 1, I have shown you, I have a bunch of data. You can play with, you can study with, okay, you can generate it if you want. So, category two. This is a cubic Hamiltonian graph that is Hamiltonian connected. One four tolerant Hamiltonian, but not Golbrich star. How to prove it? As I point out that this condition is even only, so you can. And I also mentioned day before yesterday. One spatial adjoint is and you can apply vertex expansion, just the 8 and 8. So you shrink all the three cycle, you will get a hypercube, Q3. And Q3 is a bipartite graph. Okay? Or cubic, any bipartite is definitely not 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. So that is, Globally C star is 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Then this is not 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. So this is not Globally C star. And this one is Globally C star. Definitely. It's definitely Globally C star. How? Because you shrink it, you get this. I have shown you this one. It's Globally C star. Okay? It is not Hamiltonian connected. Actually, can you prove this one is not Hamiltonian connected? Actually, I have already done before. This graph. I have shown you this graph is not Hamiltonian because I say to prove this one, I say you must do it by root and force and to get the result, this is not Hamiltonian. So, okay, this graph is not Hamiltonian connected. It's 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian, but not globally system. How to prove it? Yeah. In previous, day before yesterday, I proved this one is, remember? No, maybe it's not. Okay. This is 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Maybe. The same graph. So I have already done that before. So no problem. So if this one is 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian, then you perform expansion. You perform expansion, you will get this graph. So this graph is indeed 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Okay. So If I want to check, it is not global system. Not global system. If this one is global system, then this one must be global system. And if this one is global system, you delete a vertex, should be Hamiltonian. This one vertex has four tolerant Hamiltonian. However, it is not. Okay? The Greenberg condition, you can check with Greenberg condition. So I think what can you do? I think we have already done the generalized Petersen's graph is globally C-star connected, even on the NR. And the PN2 is globally C-star, N is 1, 2, 3. And the PN3 is 3-star, globally C-star, if N is R. And PN4 is globally C-star, if N not to 12. You can still, you can, a lot of family you can do. Right? And, yeah. So what I always ask, what can you do next? Once you have done cubic graph, you can study some spatial family of cubic graph. We want to classify it as what I mentioned. You can try all the regular graphs, and in this conference, you a lot of people propose a lot of regular graphs. You can do what is the four tolerant Hamiltonicity of the graph, right? And believe it, I always say think that if that is under the some Kelly graph, some vertex transitive, I think you got an n degree vertices. It should be n minus two four tolerant Hamiltonian, n minus three four tolerant Hamiltonian connected. It's much stronger than Lovasz conjecture. Try to prove it. Well, just a small cases you can do. It's already tough enough. Day before yesterday, I had told you a pancake graph. The pancake graph is proposed by Bill Gates. I have done something like a similar result. Like this is a pancake graph. PN is a n minus one regular graph. The definition of the pancake graph is as following. The vertices is n factorial. Any permutation of 1 to n. And the story of Bill Gates, you know, the waiter hand on the pancake with is a random permutation of a pancake, and the waiter should be make it use fork to flip it to make the order, you know, 1 to n. Okay, so this is called prefix sorting, and the corresponding result. So we have pancake graph. Each vertex is a permutation, and any two vertices are adjacent in just a frame for some places. And this must be n minus one regular. You take two copies of Pn, you make a random permutation, you make a random matching, you will get n plus one regular graph. And this graph should be n minus one vertex four tolerant Hamiltonian, n minus two four tolerant Hamiltonian connected. Believe him a lot. It is. You can prove it. Uh, I also mentioned, I don't know, if I were you, I suggest that some PhD student don't work on that, maybe don't work on the gauge problem is try to find the diameter of the pancake, right? It is very hard, you can Google it. But I can say, really there's something that can be done. In mathematics, maybe 1, 2, 3, you can. You flip it, you pick any, suppose example 4. You pick N, you pick here, you flip it, you will make this gap. Okay? However, in mathematics, you can say this is the central vertex. Everything you flip it in using this center. If you change the center, you will give another different pancake graph. And I guarantee you can find shorter diameter. Even you can find a graph with a diameter shorter than pancake graph. Because this is maybe a computer result, but I don't know. But then I don't know how to generate it. I don't know. Yeah. You can also work on general graph theory. For example, well, that is a classical result. A graph is they have a sufficient number of edges guaranteed to be Hamiltonian and guaranteed to be Hamiltonian connected. When we do have similar results, something like that. Yeah, I don't remember, but something like that. So. What can you do next? What can you do next? I don't know. We have already done this, so you can try everything we have already discussed. So let me solve. One more question is the question I posed. Day before yesterday. Where is it? I don't know. No. So maybe I go with my heart next chapter then after that. So, let's go with chapter 6. What can you do next? Oh, it's an interesting problem. You must think about it. What can I do next? So, we have another category 2, which is a branch of bipartite graph. I didn't do anything about it. Right? So, you delete one vertex, if that you can do, but I don't think you can do it because this is bipartite graph. The number of, once you delete vertices, the parents change. So you cannot do anything. Can you? So, you must, you can delete a pair of vertices.
Really?
Any pair? Yes! Okay, you can delete any pair of vertices of different color. It should remain Hamiltonian. Okay. For example, you have a branch of graph you can do this. And I say, I mean, any graph in my category 2 works. Okay? Oh, is that easy to construct such graph? Such graph must be of degree 3. Why I always insist doing cubic graph. I must, there must be some reason. So this is a graph, maybe some vertices of degree 2. Okay? And once you delete a vertex, an edge, once you delete, I mean, how you delete, once you delete a pair of vertices, I mean, you delete Z and W, you start. You cannot find it. Well, I think the young boy can understand what I'm talking about. So, all categories in category 2 are well before tolerant and tolerant. How about three joint? Can we perform three joint on category 2 to find the such graph 1P4 tolerant Hamiltonian? Well, the answer is no. Can you figure out? Well, definitely. If you drew, you make a cycle, you will think that the joint vertex the left is a. Here is a. This one should be a red, a yellow vertex, and this one is a red vertex. If you have a Hamiltonian cycle like this way, then you will have a Hamiltonian cycle here. What does that mean? You get a Hamiltonian cycle. You get a Hamiltonian cycle, a vertex called Hamiltonian cycle. It is impossible, right? The wrong parity. Right? So you cannot find a So you can what can you do at next? 1H4 tolerant Hamiltonian label. I mean what that the story is Peter Pan want to fight with Captain Hook. Okay, the crocodile, you know, you want to find a Hamiltonian path to avoid the crocodile. Okay? And, well, you understand what I mean. I think the Peter Pan and the crocodile must be in different color, right? Otherwise, you cannot find Hamiltonian paths, right? This is the only restriction. You can play the game. Well, every game you can play, yeah. Except you can play, always, yeah. So, all the graph in category 2, you can play the game. So you have a lot of map, right? Such graph, the relation, there is a relation that maybe any 1H4 tolerant Hamiltonian label is, it is 1H4 tolerant Hamiltonian. 1H4 tolerant Hamiltonian label graph is definitely the 1H4 tolerant Hamiltonian. The proof is easy. The age is 40, and you want to find the Hamiltonian path from this one to this one, right? Then, this age is 40. You want to find Hamiltonian path from this one to this one. Okay. So once you find it, then you join back. You have a Hamiltonian cycle. Okay. So let's play the game again. Again what? Try to find a Hamiltonian path for the dog and the cat and avoid the dragon. Okay? Can you do that? Once you can do it, it means something like this. You have a Hamiltonian path from these two vertices. Right? Between these two vertices. And these two vertices of the same color, you cannot do it. Can you? Maybe too easy. Yeah. Okay. Suppose you want to Captain Peter Pan and the Captain Hook is in the same color of the same located at the same color, and you want to find the, it is impossible to find Hamiltonian path. So you maybe ask the longest path you can do. The longest path you can do. So the longest path be there's also a crocodile. I mean there's also the longest path you can do. Oh, the longest path is just omit one vertex. Okay? So some vertex, not any vertex, right? You may. This is called strongly 184 tolerant Hamiltonian. And all graph in category 2 is 184 tolerant Hamiltonian lace ball. Okay? So, the next question is, play the game again. Peter Pan and Captain Cook are of the same are located at same color, and the crocodile is located in different color. The missing vertex, any red color, then you can find a, you really can find a Hamiltonian path between these two vertices. Okay. Can you play three joint again? Definitely no. I mean, definitely no. You can try. Why? If you can do that, you will find a Hamiltonian path between two paths joining two vertices of the same color. Right? So I have to stop here and solve the puzzle I give you today. You can still go. Yeah. The puzzle is, I don't remember, but I don't have the file, but I have the puzzle is you have a path of lens four. This is a parallel computer. And you want to sum eight to make any 84 remain have P4. So one choice may be
other is you can A. Any A is 40, you still have P4. So which one is better? I think maybe from mathematics point of view or from entity point of view, I think this one is better. So I mean the problem is given any graph, given any graph, you try to A some edges, and once you delete some edges, you still have the original graph. Here's the problem. The problem is like that. So the puzzle is the question I posed the day before yesterday. Can you solve? I don't know. So here is the answer. Student ate a dumpling, then he solved the problem, really. So you can everything you can think about the dumpling. Here is the dumpling. Meat. Then you ate, you made an egg here, and made an egg here, and made an egg here, and ate it here, and ate it here, and ate it here, and ate it here. What that is? I think maybe in mathematics we call it projective plan, right? So you forget the left hand side and right hand side are joined with maybe span. The upper hand and the lower band, lower part are joined with maybe span. if the mesh is 2 times 3, well, can you do that? Oh, the doubling solution tell you you need 3. You need 3, right? The projective plan tell you you need 3. However, I think 2 is enough. Because this is isomorphic to K3-3. Okay? So, how about something. But I don't remember the odd contraction right now, but I can tell you something about the even contraction. I ate 4 instead of 6. Why it works? It's interesting why it works. Maybe the graph is isomorphic to here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Something like that. Do I expand more? Maybe, yeah. Here. And this base go here. These two base go here. Okay. And A here. And the joint A here. Okay? Am I right? So, why it works? The proof is very easy. You know the joint A is maybe this one, this one, this one, this one. Right? So, you forget about this A. Forget this A. You get a tank. Roll, roll. The car is moving, right? So every 48 should be here. Can be here, right? Can be here, right? So how about the 48 is here? Well, the story is much easier. Because this is the story. Just turn everything in the other direction. Oh, that's the proof. I don't know. Yeah. I think any question, I should stop it here.